A couple of days ago, a Google internal document was leaked by a senior researcher at Google. The document was a detailed exposé into Google's current position in the AI race, and it was aptly titled, "We Have No Moat, and Neither Does OpenAI." For some background, Google has for a long time been seen as having some of the most advanced AI integration with their products. However, no one was quite ready for the release of the generative AI models by OpenAI, which quickly pushed Google to the back in terms of innovation. Still fresh in some of our memories was the bad mishap that led to the loss of $100 billion off of Alphabet's market cap, Google's parent company, and Google has since been playing catch up with OpenAI's powerful models like GPT-4 and its consumer-facing products like ChatGPT. The document makes some pretty big claims and said the quiet part out loud of what the teams at Google are thinking. The document starts off by saying, "We've done a lot of looking over our shoulders at OpenAI. Who will cross the next milestone? What will the next move be? But the uncomfortable truth is, we aren't positioned to win this arms race and neither is OpenAI. While we've been scrabbling, a third faction has been quietly eating our lunch." Honestly, at this point, I was already intrigued by the article because, if nothing else, these opening sentences show a seemingly impossible side of Google. That is, they are worried. The last line of the opening sentence then confirms my thoughts by saying, "I am of course talking about open source." Plainly put, they are lapping us. Who would have thought we'd get to see this kind of claim and statement from Google, and why is open source the tech faction that is winning the race? It all started with the leak of Meta's foundation large language model, LLaMa, in March. The massive model that had not been tuned for conversations or any specific use was suddenly available to innovators in the open source community, and barely a month later, things Google considered major problems were solved, such as having LLMs on phones, as has been seen on Pixel phones, to multimodality and the introduction of scalable personal AI. All of this was possible because the community created variants of LLaMa with previously missing features like instruction tuning, quantization, quality improvement, human evals, multimodality, LHF, and more, most of which build on each other. Google claims that the open source community has solved major scaling problems that plague the LLMs to the extent that anyone can think of. Many of the new ideas are from ordinary people. The barrier to entry for training and experimentation has dropped from the total output of a major research organization to one person, an evening, and a beefy laptop. The document makes some other intriguing claims that will run through, starting with saying why they could have seen it coming. It focuses on the similarities between the rapid innovation and iteration happening now to Stable Diffusion's open source parts that led to product integrations, marketplaces, user interfaces and innovations that didn't at all happen for DALL-E, which was not open source. It further says the effect of Stable Diffusion's open source model was rapid domination in terms of cultural impact versus OpenAI solution DALL-E, which has become increasingly irrelevant. Google acknowledges that it now only holds a slight edge over the solutions built on open source LLaMa and is worried that with the rapid innovations, it and OpenAI will soon have very little to differentiate themselves and create an appealing offering as to why users should use their products. The document further chronicled what was missed by Google, giving a lot of credit to LoRA, low-rank adaptation of LLM, saying, "LoRA is an incredibly powerful technique we should probably be paying more attention to. LoRA, which was developed by Microsoft researchers, can reduce the number of trainable parameters by tens of thousands of times, which allows model fine-tuning at a fraction of the cost and time." It then says, "The fact that LoRA exists is underexploited inside Google, even though it directly impacts some of our most ambitious projects. Seeing as LoRA updates are very cheap to produce, around $100 for the most popular model sizes, Google says that large models aren't more capable in the long run if we can iterate faster on small models, and that, in terms of engineer hours, the pace of improvement from these models vastly outstrips what we can do with our largest variants, and the best are already largely indistinguishable from ChatGPT." The next claim addresses a major issue that has plagued LLM training for a while, and that is data quality. In my previous video about ChatGPT's history change, I referenced how most of the largest LLMs are trained with unclean datasets, which is inefficient and sometimes a violation of data protection laws. The document echoes my point, saying, "Data quality scales better than data size, and many of these projects are saving time by training on small, highly curated datasets, as opposed to large, unclean datasets which create workloads for engineers when fine-tuning." Google further says that a direct competition with open source is a losing proposition and that we need them more than they need us, referring to the open source community. Google's reason for this is individuals are not as constrained by licenses to the same degree as corporations. Much of this innovation is happening on the top of leaked model weights from Meta and the legal cover afforded by personal use and the impracticality of prosecuting individuals means that individuals are getting access to these technologies while they are hot. Ironically, the winner of the race so far is Meta, seeing as they have effectively garnered the entire planet's worth of free labor. Since most open source innovation is happening on top of the architecture, there is nothing stopping them from directly incorporating it into their products. In all of this, my biggest gripe is with OpenAI being the most closed off of all LLM trainers and creators, and one would easily think the open in OpenAI stood for open source and community, but they would be wrong. The document ends by saying, in the end, OpenAI doesn't matter as they are making the same mistakes we are in their posture relative to open source. Open source alternatives can and will eventually eclipse them unless they change their stance. In this respect at least, we can make the first move. Check out this video on the ChatGPT new history setting and why OpenAI is under investigation by the EU. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.